How we doing, guys? Just getting back from my eye doctor appointment. That's why I'm wearing these sick glasses. I think these are Armani. I don't know if it's really necessary to be wearing these inside, but since I was outside, it was super bright, and I did just the eye exam, but they dilated my eyes, and I closed all the blinds. While I was driving home, because it was so bright, I got like a mini headache. So I was thinking about just like chilling for a bit before I step out into the world. I hope these things like wear out. They said 2 to 4 hours. Hoping that goes away soon. I think what I'm gonna do right now, just to kill some time, is figure out what the plan is for today and then just kind of clean up a little bit. The video for today is an actual back workout. I want to include my chili. It's no better timing than, you know, when it's cold out to make some chili. The same stuff, I like to include maybe like one different meal to stay sane. So I want to do that for you guys. Yeah, so I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna chill for a second, get that going. Hopefully this thing wears off, and then I'll check in with you guys in a bit. Change of scenery. This is actually not that bad. And I'll probably make it look better too. But I wanted to show you guys first everything that I'll be using. And for this one, oh dang it. My gum. don't mind that. So we're gonna add way more protein. Most of them don't add this much of beans, but I'm gonna do it just because I need to add more protein. And then I'll be adding the vegan sausages too. This is how they come. And I know I showed you guys before in a couple other videos. What I'm gonna do is just probably grab a stew. I think I might just do all four. And then I'll grind it up and I'll show you guys. And it'll kind of be like the like ground beef in it, or ground turkey, whatever you guys use for chili. Just salt, the cinnamon, and then ground cumin, the cayenne pepper. I grabbed a bunch of these just red peppers. They're pretty small, so that's why I'm using more. Two bigger ones would be fine. Since I like mine pretty spicy, I don't even know what these are called. They're really hot. We don't have garlic cloves or the minced garlic, so we're just gonna do the garlic salt. I think it'll be fine. I'm probably just gonna use half of that red onion. Then kidney beans, and I'll do all three of those, and that's each one has, all right, let's focus. I think it's Jesus. All right, so it's 3.5 servings, so I'm gonna do all six of them. That's fine. I saw this, and this will be my first time trying it out. This guy actually added some dark chocolate, so I'm just gonna add my cocoa powder. I actually use it for my cereal. It might sound weird, but that's actually really good. The entire can, which is basically 3 cups, just crushed tomatoes. So that's what we have, okay? And then I'll show you guys what I do to prep this. All right, guys, you wanna wash these first. Grab this. The stove, yeah, good time. Price set it at, let's do medium. Nice. Pomegranate. And then we'll turn it down a little bit. Alright, so I just cut these open down the middle. They are pretty solid. What you want to do with these is just break them down. I just use my hands and just mash it up a little bit, and it mimics the ground beef. This is what it looks like. See, it kind of looks like meat. That's 4, so it's a good amount. So we'll put that in here. Just mix it around.
gonna add a little bit of water.
So I just added some water. Add some garlic salt. Just a good amount. That should be good. And I don't really know the measurements, but just enough. Now you can kind of see. So this would be the cayenne pepper. We'll just add about that much. Then we'll add the ground cumin. Good amount. The ground cinnamon. I don't like it super sweet, so I won't put a lot, but enough to get that flavor. And then these would be the special ingredients. These are potent, be careful. And I'm gonna try to take the seeds out too. So I'm just gonna open it at the top. I should have probably done this in the garbage, but I'm just kind of emptying it out because that's gonna be really spicy. So take out the seeds. If you're adding, I'm gonna recommend you guys using your fingers. But it's already too late. I just gotta wash my hands. So I'm just gonna break these up into little pieces. The same thing with this one. All right, we'll go to the garbage. Empty that sucker out. And then we'll add a little bit of the salt. Mix it up. Add this too. Make sure it's just dark chocolate. 2.5 grams. This is a scoop for my creatine. So I'm just gonna do that and then mix it. Oh geez, that's a lot of beans. Last one. So we're putting 4. Up to you guys. Put the beans in there. Just mix it through. And that would be it. We finished the chili. Yum yum!
What's up, everyone? Just got to the gym. This is honestly the latest I've ever gone to the gym. It is 7:43. So normally I try to get to the gym, I mean, no later than 6:30. I didn't take any pre-workout just because I don't want to be up all night. The only thing I did take is the pump product, but that one has no caffeine in it. I feel pretty good. I mean, besides it being a little bit later than usual, it feels fine. I'm gonna hit a back and bicep workout. Yeah, we're gonna go get this workout. I'll check in with you guys in a bit. What's up, everyone? We got ourselves another back workout here today. For today's workout, I did include a really awesome way to warm up your back. So for me personally, I use this one for legs. It's the best way for me to really open up my hips and warm up my back enough so I don't feel like super stiff. So I would definitely recommend this workout routine. I know it's a little sped up here, but try to slow it down and watch the video a couple times and you'll really see the movements I'm doing. Most of it is just up and down, side to side, and then the rotation of the hips. So focus on those and that would help. You want to just focus on doing a lot of the stretching of your low back and opening up those hips. So at the beginning, you kind of saw me doing the cat-cows. So the cat-cows are awesome. And then after you do those, you want to do more of the mobility just at your hips instead of your entire back. So it's kind of like going up and down, side to side, stretch those legs. So that would be a great routine to use. If you guys are interested and would like to get more information on that one, I can probably do another workout or another video kind of going more in depth in that one. For me personally, I wouldn't really recommend much static stretching just in general, but after I did my warm-ups, you know, you kind of loosen up and you kind of feel yourself a lot better and less stiff than you started off. So then you can kind of incorporate a few of them, but still try to stick to those dynamic stretches. Those would be the best. Make those your best friends, and I promise you guys, you will feel a lot better throughout your workouts. After I did my warm-up, the next movement I did to warm up my back were just some scapular pull-ups. So for these, I just like to warm up and really feel my scapula retracting and tracking properly. So that will be key to getting a good warm-up and a good, well, actual functional pull-up. And it'll keep you in a nice state. So after I did that one, actually, you try to do two. Try to do two of those scapular pull-ups and then move into your pull-ups themselves. And then in here, I just went, I think I was shooting for 10. After you're warmed up with those scapular pull-ups, jump into the actual pull-up itself, and you will feel that scapula retracted, and your entire movement will just be a lot more fluid. You'll put your shoulders in a lot better position. It'll help prevent any shoulder impingement, and just the entire workout itself will just feel a lot better if you do that. After I did my pull-ups, I did this movement that I rarely do. Honestly, I can't remember the last time I've done this, but since I was trying to stick to the back corner to film most of my workout, I had to incorporate these. So these are just some variation of a lat pull-down. And I just kept an underhand grip on this one. For the angle that you want to be in, try to stick with 30 to 45 degrees. I would stick closer to the 30, but always do what feels best for you. Make sure you keep that shoulder back so you don't cause any shoulder problems. Another great workout to include in your back day would be this standing row. The main thing with this one, and the reason why I like to include things like this, is because being at this angle, standing up, you put a lot of stress on your back itself, just trying to keep yourself up. And it also puts stress on your abs, so you're kind of working out a little bit more than just your lats. The other thing I like to really focus on and incorporate as much as possible whenever I can is the unilateral movements. This would be best because you want to minimize any muscle imbalances. So for me personally, if you guys can incorporate a movement where you're using just one side, I would highly recommend. And the main focus is just to prevent any muscle imbalance and making sure that, you know, everything is growing at the same rate. And it's another thing to add, and it's kind of fun to switch it up a little bit too. I like to add a bicep workout in all of my back days. The reason me, or a lot of people, do biceps is because when you are doing when you are doing any pulling movement, the bicep is actually activated in most of those movements, and because of the actual warm-up and the use, it just kind of makes sense to kind of go with the flow and keep working out those biceps with a back day. So what I did for my biceps is a superset. And for this one, you want to keep your arm as straight as possible, parallel to the ground, and lock in your elbow. And you want to lock your elbow because you don't want to put too much stress on the shoulder. You want to focus on that bicep. So by making sure you have your arm straight out parallel and your elbow locked in, it'll put a lot more stress on the actual bicep itself, and I'll focus on that bicep peak. After doing, I believe I did 10 reps, and then I think I did a hold. So 10 sets and then a hold and then hammer curls. Me, I'm really trying to bring out my long head. So it just depends on what you're trying to do, but that's why I do these and why I incorporate these into my workouts. Last but not least, let's incorporate a couple more sets of pull-ups. I am actually just trying to build my back, and as I've said in all of my videos for back, I believe, that I'm trying to do as many pull-ups as possible. Right now, the goal is to get to 100. I surpassed the 80 mark, felt comfortable with that one. So whenever I can include pull-ups, I will do so, and since the goal is 100, I try to do them at the beginning, do my workout just because I don't want to tire myself too much at the beginning. And then I normally have a few more sets left in the tank by the end of the workout, and is what you're seeing here. Just finished the workout. Actually went a lot better than I thought. The only thing that was kind of making me doubt this workout was just because it was later, since I didn't have that pre-workout. Just a pump product. But that pump product never fails. I did most of my workouts on the cable machine, which was different. I never did that before. I kind of stuck in my little corner in the back. Did some stretching, then jumped into my standard warm-up set, which is always, or workout, the pull-ups, just because I love the stretch. Great way to start your workouts. I've always done them. I honestly would just recommend anyone that wants to warm up their back, obviously besides a little bit of stretching too. Even if you can't do a lot, it's still, you can feel it, your arms, your forearms too, you feel it in your biceps, you feel it your entire back. It's a great way to warm up. After I hit those with that pump product, I just, you know, kind of fell into place. It was a good workout. Now, heading home, I'm starving. It's already 9:30. I'm gonna have a late dinner, but it's gonna be a good one because I'm gonna have some more of that chili that I made earlier. There's a lot left. I'm so happy I made that much. I'm gonna have that, and then I'm feeling something sweet. I might do some ice cream and peanut butter. I'll let you know what I eat.
We're home, we're making some food, some dinner. I will be eating this little bowl of chili. So I got my chili, then I'm just gonna add the rest of my baby spinach on top just to give it a little bit more greens on there, because I only added peppers and onions, which I could have added a little bit more peppers too. So just to balance it out, I'm gonna eat that, and that's probably like 3 servings of beans, and then probably like 1.5 of those sausages, so a lot of protein. I already had my cereal, and I mixed in some of that the pea protein milk in there. I'm probably still going to be doing the peanut butter. So I ended up buying the same. I don't know if I showed it last time, but this is my favorite one right now. So I'm definitely gonna be having this with some peanut butter on the side. I didn't have much food this morning. And yesterday night, I didn't eat a lot either. So I'm trying to catch up for the week. That will be the end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Give it a thumbs up. Let me know what else you guys want to watch. We will continue recording and try to keep adding more things, more workouts, more info, just what I do. But yeah, thanks guys.